Hey YouTube, what's up? Blue Witch here. So, we're going to start tonight out with a tell the truth spell. Where's my foil? Seriously? Sorry, you guys. Just 1 second. Yes, we're going to start the night out with a tell the truth spell. You guys know how I feel about this spell. I'm always telling you to be careful with it. That make sure you really want to know the truth before we do this spell. And to be prepared for things to come out that you weren't expecting from everywhere. Keep your eye, it won't just come from him. It'll come from everyone. Like, all of a sudden, everybody will be telling you stuff about him. And you need to know that it's truth. Like, it's coming to you, it's being exposed to you. It works. It's amazing. I was, this is my powder for that. So I put in herbs or tell the truth herbs or something like that when I first did the spell, and, they said to me, my computer said to me, that tell the truth spells don't work, and that if you do a spell that makes someone tell the truth, that is black magic, and you should not do it. I thought it was hilarious, and I've done it many times, and every time I've done it, the truth has come out. Has been exposed within a week or two. Very, very effective spell. So please know that shit's gonna hit the fan, okay? So be ready. It's gonna happen. And this is for DF, is the person's name that we want to tell the truth. And I'm gonna write on the back of this picture. I'm going to write his name first, and then I'm going to write over the top, turn it, and then I'm going to write, I expose the truth, I expose you, I tell, you know, tell the truth, whatever. Okay? Okay, so, and then, so now, I'm going to turn it counterclockwise. Well, it doesn't really matter, because I wrote his name this way, and then from the end of his name down, I'm going to write, I expose you, truth be told, I expose you, truth be told, you know. So, that's what I'm going to write. Okay. Then I'm going to put some herbs on his face. How's he spell his name again? Anyways, I'm going to fold this up now, just like I always do, just like that. Lay this on its side. Get a little bit higher. And then, here. I don't know if you guys watched when I did this for mine. I ended up having to do it twice because mine broke. It shattered. And I thought that was a good thing. I didn't know. I thought, well, maybe. I don't know. I just wanted mine to be wrong. You know, I wanted it to be wrong, but it wasn't. And so now I know it was a good experiment, you know. And it shattered and broke, and so I redid it, and I did it again, and so as this is burning, every time I go by it, every time I stop to put energy in it, I'm going to say, I command you to tell the truth. I command you to tell the truth. I compel you to tell the truth. And I'll keep saying that, but I'll say my client's name. I command you to tell the truth. You know what I mean? And I can't do any of that on here, obviously. So this part I do on here, and then the rest, it's going over on the curse altar, and I have another truth one over there right now, and it's still burning. These do last about 5 to 7 days, or 3 days, just depends on the energy that it's receiving, if it's making good connection, things like that. Thank you. I don't usually like to add things to these candles, because I want it to be a clear reading. I want it to be a clear, you know what I mean? I don't want anything to affect the burn. And so I don't usually like to add things inside of it, but I do occasionally poke holes and then add oils to it. But, you know, I don't have to. Anyways, you guys, all right, so that's the truth-telling one, and I will be right back with who's next. What are we going to do next? Let's do the strip and remove spell next, okay? Peace out.